Hello friends, today we are going to see the problems related to cantilever beam with UDL. In previous one, we already seen the cantilever beam with point load. Okay. In previous lecture, we already seen the all sign conventions to calculating what shear force diagram and bending moment diagram. Again, we already seen the types of beams and types of loads. Okay. Now, today we are going to see that is what cantilever beam with UDL. Okay. The problem statement is that a cantilever of length 2 meter carries a uniformly distributed load of 1 kN per meter run over a length of 1.5 meter from the free end. Draw shear force and bending moment diagrams for the cantilever. Okay. This is what figure. This figure is what A to B. This is what a cantilever beam A to B. This is what cantilever beam of total span 2 meter. Okay. Now the span of UDL, that is what B to C. That is what span of UDL 1 kN per meter run. Okay. And span, that is what 1.5 meter. Okay. Now first thing is that we are going to calculate what shear force diagram. For that one, I will draw diagram here. Okay, this is what point A, this is what point B, that is total cantilever. Now this is what UDL, this is what point C. Okay, value of UDL is what 1 kN per meter run. Okay, now span is what 1.5 meter and total span is what 2 meter. Okay, first thing is that calculation of shear force diagram, calculations for shear force diagrams. Okay, now first is what shear force at B. Okay, that is what FB is equal to 0. Why 0? Means at point B there is no any force, that means at point B shear force is 0. Next is what shear force at C, that is FC is equal to, okay, this point C. Okay, at point C, what is the, which force is acting here? This is what UDL. Okay. Now what is the value of UDL? Convert this UDL into point load. How to convert this UDL into point load? I will show here. Okay. This is what UDL. Okay. This is what span. 1.5 meter. This is what span of UDL. And value of UDL is what? 1 kN per meter run. Okay. If we convert this UDL into point load, the value comes here what? 1 into 1.5. That is 1.5 kN. Okay. So, up to point C, only one force is there, that is UDL. If we convert UDL into point load, the value we got, that is 1.5 kN. So, simply 1.5 kN. This is what? Shear force at point C. Okay. Next, shear force at A. Okay. See this figure. From point C to A, there is no any load is there. That means whatever value we got at point C, this is constant up to point A. That means shear force at A, that is 1.5 kN. Okay. So, see here at point B, what we got the value, that is shear force, that is 0. Okay, then at C we got the value of shear force, that is 1.5 kN, and point A, that is what, one value of C, that is constant up to point A, that is what, 1.5 kN. Okay, this is point A, this is point B, this is C. Okay, this is D and E. This is what positive shear force diagram. This is what shear force diagram. Okay, we got this shear force diagram, or we draw the shear force diagram from these calculations. Okay, now next step is what? calculations for bending moment diagram. Okay. Now next, see here. First is what? Bending moment at point B. Okay. Now at point B, we already discussed the what, all the sign conventions required for shear force diagram and bending moment diagram. For bending moment diagram, we are going to assume sagging and hogging, otherwise anti-clockwise, clockwise direction. Okay. Next is what? At point B, this is what, free end of this cantilever. So simply what, the bending moment at B is equal to zero. Okay. Next is what, bending moment at C. Now this is point C. Bending moment at C, MC is equal to, now how to calculate the bending moment at C? Suppose I will draw this part separately here. Okay. This is what, UDL. This is point C, this is point B. Okay. Total span 1.5 meter. Value of UDL 1 kilonewton per meter run. Okay. Convert into point load, that is 1 into 1.5. So this value is 1.5 kilonewton. This is what point load. Where it acts? It acts at the center of this band. That means from point C, it acts at 0.75 meter. From B, it's act at 0.75 meter. Okay. Now we are calculating bending moment at point C. Okay. Which force we are going to consider here? This is what, a point load. That is 1.5. Okay. 1.5 kilonewton into perpendicular distance. That means distance from point C. What is the distance? 0.75. That means sign is minus. 1.5 into distance 0.75. This is what, force. We converted this UDL into point load, that is 1.5 kilonewton, and this is what, distance. So simply from this, if we calculate this one, so value we get minus 1.125 kilonewton meter, because kilonewton meter means this is a product of these two. Okay, this is what kilonewton, this is what in meter. So simply kilonewton meter. Next, this is what, bending moment at C. This is bending moment at B. Okay, now next, bending moment at A, that is MA. Okay, now see this figure. Okay, from this A, okay, where this point load acts, point load may be act here. Okay, so this distance is nothing but what, A to C 0.5. okay, and C to this point load, this distance is nothing but what, 0.75. again I will draw here separately. Suppose this point A is here, point C is here, okay, and this point B is here. Okay, A to C distance is what, 0.5. okay, and this C to B, this is 1.5. this is what, total UDL. Okay, UDL to conversion into point load, that is, if we convert, that is 1.5 kilonewton. It's act from C, distance is what, 0.75. now we are calculating bending moment at A. Okay, the force is what, 1.5. okay, into perpendicular distance. Distance is nothing but what, this 0.5 plus this 0.75. so simply minus 1.5 into distance is what, 0.5 plus 0.75 is equal to, so value comes around minus 1.875 kilonewton meter. That is bending moment at A. Okay, so from this calculation we draw bending moment here, C see here. At B point, bending moment is 0, that is free end, bending moment is 0. Okay, now next, at point C, bending moment is minus 1.125. This is what? Minus 1.125.